In this demonstration, we're going to look at how to draw a scatter plot. And to do this, we're going to use the data from lectures again, which is the stature data. So first thing I'm going to do is import the data set, comma separated values, OK. I've already downloaded the data, and there it is. It's called stature. So just open that data. We view the data set. You can see that it's a relatively small data set. It's only got 9 observations in it. The first column is the metacarpal length in millimeters of the hand bone, and the stature is the height in centimeters for a bunch of individuals. And we're interested in the relationship between these two. More particularly, we're interested in whether you can predict stature from metacarpal length. So how do we do a scatter plot? Okay, well, a scatter plot is a graph, so it's under the graphs menu, and you can see about halfway down a box that says scatter plot. Okay, the first thing we see is this screen. We choose whether to which variable is going to go on the x-axis and which variable is going to go on the y-axis. Since I'm particularly interested in looking at how stature relates to metacarpal length, I'm going to put metacarp on the x-axis and stature on the y-axis. Now, we need to tick the options box here, and there's an enormous number of options for this thing. The main thing I want to do is untick smooth line and show spread. For this data set, those are largely meaningless and they're complex to explain in any case. So we'll just untick those two so that we can't see them. Okay, and then we click OK. And there you see a scatter plot. Now it may be a little bit difficult to see the points on that plot. You can see that a couple of the most outlying points have been labelled. Each dot, each little circle represents one of the data points for that metacarpal length and scatter and stature. And the green line has been drawn. Now this is the least squares regression line, which we'll talk about in future lectures, but for the moment you can just ignore that. On each of the axes, there's a schematic box plot of the individual measurements for metacarp and stature. You can see that stature has a few outlying points. And it's quite difficult to see the points, so let's see how we can make that more visible. If we go back to graphs, scatter plot again, in the options pane, there's a couple of things that we can do here. We can change all the labels. You can see the top right there, labels. The thing I'm particularly interested in, the plotting characters box here. If we want to make the plotting characters a solid circle, we actually change that to 16. That's the code for a solid circle. We'll also make them a bit bigger, so we'll change this point size to about 1.5. That increases the size of the dots by 50%. If we now click OK, we see much more clearly where the data points are, big black dots, and you can just about see the green line, which is the regression line. We'll talk about that another time. Okay, so that's scatterplots. Thank you very much.